My name is Lars Santana. I'm a district conservationist with the USDA's Natural Resources Conservation Service. Here in the West, water is a very precious commodity. It's the lifeblood for all our agricultural operations. So every drop counts. As we become more efficient with our irrigation systems and our delivery systems to the water users, they're able to harness every drop out there.
Three Sisters Irrigation District is about 7,600 acres, and historically, the whole reason that irrigation modernization became our number one priority was because we had a 55% system loss. So we used to divert 35,000 acre feet and deliver 17,000 on farm.
It's really important to conserve water in Central Oregon because we live in a desert. This is the high desert, and 100 plus years ago when the area was resettled by non-tribal folks, the imperative was to essentially bring the desert to life and make it productive. And in that process, we essentially took all the water out of the streams to do that. Huge stretches of river and creeks are now running dry or have run dry in the summer months.
The water users would pump water out of ponds to get to their fields. And these ponds were fed by this series of open ditches and canals. It was not very efficient. And now that their piping and pressurized water is available to them, they're able to convert from flood irrigation techniques to more modern and more efficient sprinkler irrigation techniques, as well as drip irrigation.
So it wasn't hard to figure out that all we needed to do was start piping the canals, capture that water, and then we were able to dedicate half of the conserve water to the stream to bring back steelhead, salmon, and bull trout, and the other 25% or the other half of the water went to the farmers, which then gave them a 25% increase in on-farm availability.
There's a combination of benefits to a project like this that involve, for one thing, delivering the farmers the water that they need in order to be productive. In a water short situation, they're limited on what kinds of crops they can grow and what kinds of yields they can get from the crops that they're growing. From an energy standpoint, the fact that they're getting pressurized water means that they don't have to have pumps connected to the system. If you don't have pumps, then there's a certain amount of electricity that you're not using that isn't a demand on the electrical grid. And then from a non-farm standpoint, if you're not diverting water from the creek, that water is available for fish and recreators and landscape and the environment.
So right now, we are standing here in an example of an on-farm irrigation project. Here you can see some center pivot sprinkler systems that we were able to work with this landowner to basically tie into an existing pressurized system. Now, this does a couple things. This helps reduce the need for pumping. In some cases, we were able to completely eliminate the need for pumping. In other cases, we've been using variable frequency drive pumps to help augment or offset the needs for pumping. In either case, the energy demand has been reduced greatly for these landowners.
I'm John Herman, the owner and operator of the Lazy Z Ranch and Lazy Z Ranch Wines. And here we are doing bee ranching. So we're pretty diversified. We have grass hay production. We do ultra high density grazing of beef cattle. And then bee colony sales and honey production as well. So the Lazy Z used to be flood irrigated. Three Sisters Irrigation has piped the entirety of our district now. It was brought on farm with a very short extension of mainline. And then we were doing a lot of above ground mainline. We were using big gun sprinklers that require incredible amounts of manual labor to move them every couple hours all over the property. And we were in the middle of a drought. So it was like, we only have so much water that we can use. And we were using it. And now that we've got the underground mainline, we've got these pivots, we can really be targeted in irrigating so much more of our property with so much less water.
So it's really just a win-win for everyone. The farmers get what they need, the creek ends up with water in it, the fish are happy. It's a good story to tell.
This has just been a tremendous success. There's really nothing like this in the state, but currently right now, all of Central Oregon is moving in this direction to irrigation modernization, and PL 566 and RCPP are two of the main driving factors that are helping those districts get to where they need to basically create sustainable water And right now, TSID, or Three Sisters Irrigation District, has basically achieved drought and climate resiliency. And that's something that sometimes it takes more than a lifetime to do, and we've managed to do it in 25 years.
Yeah, a project like this can really not happen without the community and the landowner involvement. They're the ones who really make this happen. Without their support and their efforts to improve the environment around us, this can never happen. It's been truly amazing to work on a conservation effort like this. It's incredible to see all the diverse partners come together and work collaboratively on a common vision of restoring the Whychus Creek watershed while supporting a sustainable agricultural community. And it's incredible to see all these conservation puzzle pieces coming together to form a solution, and it goes to show what people can do when they're all working together on a common vision.
It's been a phenomenal success story. NRCS has been literally the founding partner from day one. All these things combined with all the other partners from Bureau of Reclamation and Deschutes River Conservancy, and you know, there's over 50 different partners. We have developed an incredible success story of restoring the stream, putting in fish screening and passage, and basically opening up the stream and helping the tribes and PGE bring back the anadromous runs to the Deschutes Basin in Whychus Creek.
We could not have done this on our own. This was a ton of people coming together to do this with and for us. And it's changed the way we farm. Changes our life, really.